This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In morphology and syntax, a clitic from Greek klitikos, inflectional, is a morpheme that has syntactic characteristics of a word, but depends phonologically on another word or phrase. In this sense, it is syntactically independent but phonologically dependent, always attached to a host. The term is derived from the Greek for leaning. A clitic is pronounced like an affix, but plays a syntactic role at the phrase level. In other words, clitics have the form of affixes, but the distribution of function words, for example, the contracted forms of the auxiliary verbs in I'm and weve are clitics. Clitics can belong to any grammatical category, although they are commonly pronouns, determiners, or adpositions. Note that orthography is not always a good guide for distinguishing clitics from affixes. Clitics may be written as separate words, but sometimes they are joined to the word on which they depend, like the Latin clitic k, meaning end, or separated by special characters such as hyphens or apostrophes, like the English clitic s. The word clitic is often used loosely for what may be better described as an affix or word. Citation needed. Contents 1. Classification 11. Proclitic 12. Enclitic 13. Mesoclitic 14. Endoclitic 2. Distinction 21. Simple clitics 22. Special clitics 3. Properties 31. Prosody 32. Comparison with affixes 33. Comparison with words 34. Word order 4. Indo-European languages 41. Germanic languages 411. English 412. Other Germanic languages 42. Romance languages 43. Proto-Indo-European 44. Slavic languages 5. Other languages 6. See also 7. References. Classification. This section may be confusing or unclear to readers. In particular, it is unclear which words or parts of words are clitics. In the examples, July 2014. Learn how and when to remove this template message. Clitics fall into various categories depending on their position in relation to the word to which they are connected. Proclitic. A proclitic appears before its host. It is common in Romance languages. For example, in French, there is Il s'est réveillé. He woke up, or Je t'aime. I love you. Enclitic. And enclitic appears after its host. Latin, senatus populusque Romanus, senate people, and Roman equals the senate and people of Rome. Ancient Greek, anthropoite theoite, people and gods, and equals both men and gods. Sanskrit, naro gajaska equals naro gajaska. Endoclitic. The endoclitic splits apart the root and is inserted between the two pieces. Endoclitics defy the lexical integrity hypothesis or lexicalist hypothesis, and so were long claimed to be impossible. However, evidence from the Udi language suggests that they exist. Endoclitics are also found in Pashto and are reported to exist in Digma. Distinction 1. Important distinction divides the broad term clitics into two categories, simple clitics and special clitics. This distinction is, however, disputed. Simple clitics. Simple clitics are free morphemes, meaning they can stand alone in a phrase or sentence. They are unaccented and thus phonologically dependent upon a nearby word. They only derive meaning from this host. Special clitics. Special clitics are morphemes that are bound to the word they are dependent upon, meaning they exist as a part of their host. This form, which is unaccented, represents a variant of a free form that does carry stress, while the two variants carry similar meaning and phonological makeup. The special clitic is bound to a host word and unaccented properties. Some clitics can be understood as elements undergoing a historical process of grammaticalization. Lexical item clitic affix. According to this model from Judith Clavins, an autonomous lexical item in a particular context loses the properties of a fully independent word over time and acquires the properties of a morphological affix, prefix, suffix, infix, etc. At any intermediate stage of this evolutionary process, the element in question can be described as a clitic. As a result, this term ends up being applied to a highly heterogeneous class of elements, presenting different combinations of word-like and affix-like properties. Prosody. One characteristic shared by many clitics is a lack of prosodic independence. A clitic attaches to an adjacent word, known as its host. Orthographic conventions treat clitics in different ways. Some are written as separate words, some are written as one word with their hosts, and some are attached to their hosts, but set off by punctuation, a hyphen, or an apostrophe. For example, comparison with affix. Although the term clitic can be used descriptively to refer to any element whose grammatical status is somewhere in between a typical word and a typical affix, linguists have proposed various definitions of clitic as a technical term. One common approach is to treat clitics as words that are prosodically deficient, they cannot appear without a host, and they can only form an accentual unit in combination with their host. The term postlexical clitic is used for this narrower sense of the term given this basic definition. Further criteria are needed to establish a dividing line between postlexical clitics and morphological affixes. Since both are characterized by a lack of prosodic autonomy, there is no natural, clear-cut boundary between the two categories, since from a historical point of view, a given form can move gradually from one to the other by morphologization. However, by identifying clusters of observable properties that are associated with core examples of clitics on the one hand, and core examples of affixes on the other, one can pick out a battery of tests that provide an empirical foundation for a clitic affix distinction. An affix syntactically and phonologically attaches to a base morpheme of a limited part of speech, such as a verb, to form a new word. A clitic syntactically functions above the word level, on the phrase or clause level, and attaches only phonetically to the first, last, or only word in the phrase or clause, whichever part of speech the word belongs to. The results of applying these criteria sometimes reveal that elements that have traditionally been called clitics actually have the status of affixes, e.g., the Romance pronominal clitics discussed. Below, Zwicky and Pullum postulated five characteristics that distinguish clitics from affixes. Clitics do not select their hosts, that is, they are promiscuous, attaching to whichever word happens to be in the right place. Affixes do select their host, they only attach to the word they are connected to semantically, and generally attach to a particular part of speech. Clitics do not exhibit arbitrary gaps. Affixes, on the other hand, are often lexicalized and may simply not occur with certain words. English plural s, for example, does not occur with child. Clitics do not exhibit morphophonological idiosyncrasies, that is, they follow the morphophonological rules of the rest of the language. Affixes may be irregular in this regard. Clitics do not exhibit semantic idiosyncrasies, that is, the meaning of the phrase plus clitic is predictable from the meanings of the phrase, and the clitic affixes may have irregular meanings. Clitics can attach to material already containing clitics, and affixes can attach to other affixes, but not to material containing clitics. Comparison with words similar to the discussion above, clitics must be able to be distinguished from words. There have been a number of linguistic tests proposed to differentiate between the two categories. Some tests, specifically, are based upon the understanding that when comparing the two, clitics resemble affixes, while words resemble syntactic phrases. Clitics and words resemble different categories in the sense that they share certain properties with them. Six such tests are described below. These, of course, are not the only ways to differentiate between words and clitics. If a morpheme is bound to a word and can never occur in complete isolation, then it is likely a clitic. In contrast, a word is not bound and can appear on its own. If the addition of a morpheme to a word prevents further affixation, then it is likely a clitic. If a morpheme combines with single words to convey a further degree of meaning, then it is likely a clitic. A word will combine with a group of words or phrases to denote further meaning if a morpheme is required to be in a certain order with respect to other morphemes within the construction, then it is likely a clitic. Independent word words enjoy free ordering with respect to other words, within the confines of the word order of the language. If a morpheme's allowable behavior is determined by one principle, it is likely enclitic. For example, a precedes indefinite nouns in English. Words can rarely be described with one such description. In general, words are more morphologically complex than clitics. Clitics are rarely composed of more than one morpheme. Word order. Clitics do not always appear next to the word or phrase that they are associated with. Grammatically, they may be subject to global word order constraints that act on the entire sentence. Many Indo-European languages, for example, obey Wackernagel's law, named after Jacob Wackernagel, which requires clitics to appear in second position, after the first syntactic phrase or the first stressed word in a clause. Latin had three enclitics that appeared in second or third position of a clause: enum, indeed, for, autem, but, moreover, vero, however. For example, quis enum potest neger, from Marshall's epigram LXIV, literally, who indeed can deny. Spevec 2010 reports that in her corpus of Caesar, Cicero and Sallust, these three words appear in such position in 100% of the cases. Indo-European languages. Germanic languages. English. English enclitics include the contracted versions of auxiliary verbs, as in I'm and weve. Some also regard the possessive marker, as in the Queen of England's crown, as an enclitic, rather than a phrasal genitival inflection. The negative marker ent, as in couldn't, etc., is often thought to be a clitic developed from the lexical item. Not linguists. Arnold Zwicky and Jeffrey Pullum argue, however, that the form has the properties of an affix rather than a syntactically independent clitic. Other Germanic languages. Old Norse, the definite article was the enclitic in, itt masculine, feminine and neuter nominative singular, as in Alfrin, the elf, Jofin, the gift, and Treit, the tree, an abbreviated form of the independent pronoun hin, cognate of the German pronoun gender. It was fully declined for gender, case and number since both the noun and enclitic were declined. This led to double declension. The situation remains similar in modern Faroese and Icelandic, but in Danish, Norwegian and Swedish, the enclitics have become endings Dutch t definite article of neuter nouns and third-person singular neuter pronoun, k first-person pronoun, j second-person singular pronoun, i.e. third-person masculine singular pronoun, z third-person plural pronoun plotdeutsch, dit it vandoag, will he do it today? Gothic, sentence clitics appear in second position in accordance with Wackernagel's law, including u yes no question, and, then, anything, for example ab uus silben of thyself. Multiple clitics can be stacked up, and will split a proverb from the rest of the verb if the proverb comes at the beginning of the clause, e.g. dis an sat ehos and then he seized them fem, ga u a se whether he saw anything. Romance languages. In the Romance languages, the object personal pronoun forms are sometimes claimed to be clitics, others claim that they are actually affixes, as they only attach to the verb they are the object of. There is no general agreement on the issue in Spanish, for example, lo atamos, it tied minus one petaliter equals we tied it, can only occur with the verb it is the object of. Damelo, give me it. Colloquial European Portuguese allows object suffixes before the conditional and future suffixes of the verbs, ela levelo ia, she take it would, she would take it, els dar no lo ao, they give us it will, they will give it to us. Colloquial Portuguese of Brazil and Portugal and Spanish of the former Gran Colombia allow esser to be conjugated as a verbal clitic adverbial adjunct to emphasize the importance of the phrase compared to its context or with the meaning of really or in truth. Ele estava era gordo, he was fat, he was very fat. Ele ligou a para Paula, he phoned is Paula, he phoned Paula, with emphasis. Note that this clitic form is only for the verb esser and is restricted to only third-person singular conjugations. It is not used as a verb in the grammar of the sentence but introduces prepositional phrases and adds emphasis. It does not need to concord with the tense of the main verb, as in the second example, and can be usually removed from the sentence without affecting the simple meaning. Proto-Indo-European. In the Indo-European languages, some clitics can be traced back to Proto-Indo-European, for example, ke is the original form of Sanskrit ka-ca, Greek te te, and Latin k Latin, k and ve or nay yes no question Greek te and de but gar for in a logical argument, and therefore Slavic languages Russian, li yes no question, z emphasis, to emphasis, nay not proclitic, by subjunctive. Czech, special clitics, weak personal and reflexive pronouns mu, him, certain auxiliary verbs by, would, and various short particles and adverbs too, here, ale, though, napodarilo by se mi mu de dat. I would not succeed in giving it to him. In addition, there are various simple clitics including short prepositions Polish, by conditional mood particle, psi reflexive, also modifies meaning of certain verbs, no emphasis, m, s, smi, ski personal auxiliary, mi, c, go, mu. Arabic, suffixes standing for direct object pronouns and or indirect object pronouns as found in Indo-European languages are suffixed to verbs, possessive determiners are suffixed to nouns, and pronouns are suffixed to particles ganda, na attached to a verb to form the progressive, wo, in, also attached to a verb Somali. Pronominal clitics, either subject or object clitics, are required in Somali. These exist as simple clitics postponed to the noun they apply to. Lexical arguments can be omitted from sentences, but pronominal clitics cannot be. See also clitic climbing clitic doubling genitive case grammatical particle possessive case separable affix tmesis weak and strong forms in English weak pronoun. References Carrot SIL International 2003 SIL Glossary of Linguistic Terms, What is a Clitic? This page is an extract from the Lingualinks Library, version 50 published on CD-ROM by SIL International, 2003. Retrieved from http://usalorg/linguistics/glossaryoflinguisticterms/whatisaclitic/grammatum caret ABCD Crystal, David A. First Dictionary of Linguistics and Phonetics Boulder, Colorado, Westview, 1980 Print caret Harris, Alice C. 2002 Endoclitics and the Origins of UDI Morphosyntax Oxford, Oxford University Press ISBN. Clitics in Alexandra Galani, Glyn Hicks. 14 Carat Huddleston, Rodney, Pullum, Jeffrey 2002 The Cambridge Grammar of the English Language Cambridge, New York, Cambridge University Press pp. Retrieved 28 March 2007.